Yes sir, good morning to all of you. Myself Mahesh Jagdish Pingle, lecturer electronics engineering, government polytechnic Ambad. So dear students, our today's point of discussion, it is related with the polarization of the antenna, or it is also called as antenna polarization. So before moving to that particular part, first of all we must know what exactly we mean by the polarization, right? Now, first of all, let us have some look over the term that is called as TEM wave. So the full form of TEM wave, it is transverse electromagnetic wave. I will repeat once again, the wave, it is called as TEM wave. So full form of TEM wave, it is nothing but transverse electromagnetic wave. So what exactly we mean by the transverse electromagnetic wave? So in wireless communication, whenever we are sending information from one point to the another point, whatever the mode of propagation through the free space, it is TEM. So that particular electromagnetic wave has TEM nature, right? So suppose if you want to send signal from A point to suppose B point, so whatever the wave transmitted through the wireless, right? So it is nothing but having a nature called as TEM, and the full form of TEM, it is nothing but transverse electromagnetic. Now exactly, let us have a look what exactly we mean by the transverse electromagnetic wave. Transverse electromagnetic wave are the waves in which both electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other as well as perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. So electromagnetic wave is nothing but the combination of two fields. First field, it is called as electric field, and second field, it is called as the magnetic field. Quite obvious, the EM fields, that is called electromagnetic fields, that is electric field and the magnetic field, are always perpendicular to the each other. So here in this diagram you are observing, suppose this is the dotted lobe, it is called as the E field. So whatever the elliptical nature, circular nature, here describing E field, H field. So dotted lines describing H field, H is nothing but the magnetic field, and the solid line circle itself indicating your electric field. So if the electric field is in horizontal plane, then the magnetic field is in vertical plane. So whatever the separation angle between these two field, so angular separation between these two field, it is 90 degree. So we can say that electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. Similarly, here you are observing there is one another electric field and magnetic field combination. So this is your electric field, this is your magnetic field, once again perpendicular to each other, and so on. So everywhere we are observing electric field, that is solid line, and the magnetic field, dotted line, are always perpendicular to each other. So the same thing we have observed here, the electric field and the magnetic field. So electric field and the magnetic field, both are perpendicular to each other. Now they are perpendicular to each other, and both are perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. So this is the fulfillment of TEM concept. Means electric field and magnetic field both are perpendicular to each other as well as they are perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. So this is the postulate for your TEM wave. In this particular wave you are observing, so this is electric field sinusoidal wave and this is your magnetic field wave. Now electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. So suppose if I am saying that electric field is in vertical plane, right? At that time, whatever the magnetic field, it is in horizontal plane. So they are perpendicular to each other as well as perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. So suppose Z is the direction of wave propagation. So electric field is perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation Z, as well as magnetic field is also perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation Z, and meanwhile they are mutually perpendicular to each other. So this is the satisfaction case of your TEM wave. Now it is not always the case that every time your electric field should be in horizontal plane or it should be in vertical plane. It may be anything. So when electric field is in vertical plane, the magnetic field should be in horizontal plane. If the electric field is in horizontal plane, the magnetic field should be in your vertical plane. So polarization gives us the information of electric field vector, right? So if the electric field vector, it is in vertical plane, then it is called as vertically polarized antenna. And if the electric field vector, it is in horizontal plane, then we can say that it is horizontally polarized antenna. So let us have a look over this particular polarization definition of the antenna. So polarization or antenna polarization is defined as the direction of electric vector in the electromagnetic wave radiated from an antenna. So whatever the antenna you are using, that will radiate some electromagnetic energy into the free space. So after the radiation, we have to observe the position of the electric vector. So the direction of the electric vector in the electromagnetic wave radiated from the antenna. If the electric field vector, it is in horizontal plane, then it is called as horizontally polarized antenna. And if the electric field vector, it is in vertical plane, then it is called as the vertically polarized antenna. Now basically, the low frequency, very low frequency and the medium frequencies antenna are vertically polarized. So because of the low frequencies antenna, so low, very low, medium frequencies antenna, all these frequencies lie within the low frequency category. So for the low frequencies, the antennas are always vertically polarized due to the proximity of the ground. But if we want to design the higher frequencies antenna, there is some assumption, and we can take that as a treatment, that the higher frequency antenna should be horizontally polarized. So the whatever the antenna we have designed for the higher frequencies, they should be horizontally polarized. Why they should be horizontally polarized? Because whatever the noise made from man-made noise or the industrial noise, all these noise are vertically polarized. So if we design the antenna for the higher frequencies vertically polarized, and we are also having a man-made noise which are also vertically polarized, so that will create some noise within that particular transmitted signal. So it is harmful for the perfect communication. So that's why what we have done, if the noise is present in vertically polarized antenna, so let us have designed the antenna for higher frequencies which is horizontally polarized. So whatever the polarization of man-made noise and transmitted electric field vector, it is completely different. So no noise will be added within that particular signal. So I will repeat once again. So polarization is defined as the direction of electric vector in the electromagnetic wave radiated from the antenna. The LF, VLF, MF antennas are vertically polarized due to the proximity of the ground. For higher frequencies, we use horizontally polarized antenna so that the radiation is not affected by the vertically polarized man-made noise. So this is all about the antenna polarization. Thank you very much.